Welcome to this video on special effects in PaintShop Pro. In this tutorial, you will learn how to use the Selective Focus tool to create a depth of field effect and increase saturation, how to apply the Sepia effect to give a flare of the retro to an image, how to use the time machine effects, and three easy ways to create a vignette frame. Selective Focus is a great way to make part of an image stand out from the rest. This is also the tool of choice if you've been considering creating a desktop wallpaper from one of your photographs. First, open the image in PaintShop Pro and make sure that the Edit tab is active. Next, from the Effects menu, select Photo Effects, and then Selective Focus. The Selective Focus tool is quite versatile, allowing you to select an area of an image to focus on using a linear, circular, or freehand selection. In this example, we will use the Circular Selection tool as it allows you to adjust the shape and create an oval around this ladybug. With the Preview on image checked, changes made on the Selective Focus window can be seen on the image below. You can increase the blur to make the background as blurry as you like. By increasing the feather edge, you're creating a more gradual fade from the sharp portion of the image to the blurry portion. A large feather will create a smoother look. Saturation is an option seen in many areas throughout PaintShop Pro, and it's also available through the Selective Focus tool. If you do not wish to increase the color saturation, set this value to 0. In this example, the saturation will be set to 60 to give the image a more vibrant appearance. When the adjustments have been made, click OK. If you enjoy taking photos of antiques or have a special image representative of history, such as a photo taken at a historical site, museum, or event, the Sepia effect can give these images that retro edge and make them really stand out. To apply this effect, simply open the image, click on Effects, Photo Effects, and then Sepia Toning. Make sure that there is a check mark in Preview on Image. Adjustments available for Sepia range between 1 and 100. At the lower end of the scale is black and white. The higher end of the scale will add more copper to the appearance. In this example, we will use 75%. When you've finished, click OK, and the effect will be applied to the image. A similar effect unique to PaintShop Pro is the Time Machine, which not only allows you to mimic photographic styles throughout the last two centuries, it also gives a history lesson while you use it. For this example, we will be using a photo representative of time to demonstrate these effects. From the Effects menu, select Photo Effects, and then Time Machine. When the Time Machine window opens, you will be able to see a range of photographic styles from 1839 until 1960. In the bottom portion of the window are 7 examples of how your photo would look if it were processed using these various techniques throughout the ages. As you click on each thumbnail, the name will appear below, followed by a brief description of the time period when the processing was used and how the development processes took place. With Preview on Image selected, you can see the changes take place on your image as you click on each thumbnail. Photo edges are meant to represent the styles of paper commonly used with each processing style. You can choose to turn these edges off, but in this example, we'll leave them on. When you've made your selection, click OK to continue. There are 3 quick and easy ways to create a vignette frame around your image, and which is the best way is simply a matter of personal preference. The first method is to delete the outside portion of the image, leaving behind the frame. To do this, first select the background color from the Materials palette. This will serve as the frame color. In this example, we will select an olive green color. Select it as the foreground and the background color from the Materials for the purpose of this demonstration. choose the selection tool from the standard toolbar. In the Interactive Properties bar, select the Ellipse tool from the selection types. Set the feather to 50, and draw an ellipse around the area of the image you wish to frame. Go to the Selections menu, and then choose Invert Selection. Next, hit the Delete key on your keyboard. This will replace the selected area with the background color you chose earlier. The second method is to create a new layer which will serve as the frame and then remove the center portion to show the image behind it. To do this, go to Layers and select Create New Raster Layer. You will see the new layer appear in the Layers palette on the right-hand side of your screen. If you do not see it, click the F8 key on your keyboard to view this palette. From the standard toolbar, select the Flood Fill tool and click on the image. Next, choose the Selection tool from the standard toolbar. Once again, make sure that the ellipse has been chosen from the selection type in the Interactive Properties bar. In this example, we will set the feather to 100 to make sure that there is a gradual fade around the inside edges. To see the image better so that you can be sure to cut out the correct portion of the frame, you can always adjust the opacity of the layer at the top of the Layers palette. Now, simply hit the Delete key on your keyboard. You can increase the opacity of your frame either partially so that some of the image shows through, or all the way back to 100% or full opacity. The third method is to use the pre-made picture frame, Antique Vignette, which is located in the Picture Frames under the Image menu. After you've selected the frame, you have the option to choose to frame just that layer or the entire project, place the frame inside the image or outside the image, which will include a border. The frame can also be flipped, mirrored, or rotated. For the purpose of this example, we will leave the settings to frame the entire canvas outside of the image and rotate it to the right. When you finish choosing the settings, click OK, and the frame will appear as a new layer titled Picture Frames in the Layer palette. Like the previous example, because this frame is a layer on top of an image, the opacity can be altered so as to show part of the image through the frame. Thank you for watching this video on special effects in Corel PaintShop Pro.